AD Damon.
BBC Radio Leicester.
Well, next this afternoon, what are your first thoughts? Into your mind, if I was to say bodybuilding, would it be fake tan, muscles, maybe a man flexing his arms in little swimming trunks? Well, that's the stereotypical view, isn't it? But what about female bodybuilders? There's a huge rise in females taking part in weightlifting, powerlifting and bodybuilding. And in an age where body confidence is a huge problem, how can we promote this further? Well, Martine Warman is aiming to do just this and joins us now. Very good afternoon to you, Martine.
Afternoon.
Thank you ever so much for joining us. Martine, tell me about your story, because you're British champion, European champion. You know, you've had an incredible career in this.
Yeah, well, I started off with powerlifting, and that was something that I particularly enjoyed. And it was actually through coincidence when I injured myself that I didn't want to. I like to train for something, so I like to compete, and that's just what I like to do. So when I got injured, I knew that on the recovery process, heavy weights was out of the question, so to speak. Well, for powerlifting anyway. So then I actually ventured into bikini fitness. And then there's bikini fitness, bodybuilding, loads of different categories now. And that's something that I wanted to do because it was a change, because the training would allow me to do it even with an injury. And I wanted to push myself and see if I could do it.
And what was it like, you know, getting started with this? Was it quite unusual? Because like we said, you know, is there a big misconception that bodybuilding is a male sport?
I think there was more so, but now so with so many different categories within that arena, I don't think it's as distant, if you like, as a category. So when I first started, I knew lots of different people that were into bikini fitness, but now there are so many more people into it. And I think that's because of things like Instagram influencers, Instagram famous people, and people wanting to be like that. They feel like, oh, I need a platform, maybe I should compete, that gives me recognition, then I can get sponsorship, and then who knows where it can go from there.
So is it a case of social media has inspired this generation? So as you say, you know, for bikini fitness, for weightlifting, for powerlifting,
yeah.
Is that the main movement and the push behind people?
Yeah, I think that's definitely come to the forefront more than powerlifting, because it's getting a lot more limelight because of Instagram fame people and all that type of stuff. So yeah, it's got into people's head. That's because of social media. And if you go on social media, whatever you follow, I can guarantee you can see pictures of bikinis and people prepping for their competitions, and that's male and female. So it's definitely the front of people's mind.
Is this a case as well of not that anybody can do this, and I'm not decrying this by any stretch, but
yeah.
We are very much a social media-led generation, aren't mm-hmm. we? Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, television, we switch it on, you know, everybody always looking at their best.
Yeah.
Is this a case that this can inspire anybody, any female, to get involved with this?
I think it can, because I believe anything's possible anyway. Anything you put your mind to, you can achieve. And I think because of the increase in the amount of people that want to do this type of sport, before there was a few federations, now there's a lot of different federations, so many federations I couldn't even possibly name them, but they've all got their own categories within them. So for example, with the federation I started with, I did bikini fitness. After that category, there was body fitness. So for bikini, you need to be slightly slimmer and smaller. For body fitness, you need to have a bit more muscle. And I fitted in bikini. But now there's another section in between that has come out since I've stopped, which is called wellness. So for wellness people, if you're not got a small enough frame for bikini, but you're not big enough to do body fitness, you can now fit in the wellness category. So there are so many more categories than when I first started, with lots of different federations that do tattooed and strong, new mum, teens. There are so many that if you look at across the broad board now, there's a category that you will fit into. So it's opened up more opportunities for everyone, really.
We'll talk about new mum as well in a minute, because I know this is almost your speciality as well, certainly
yeah.
What you're working on. We'll speak about that more in a minute. But, you know, how important is it that with these categories now, that anybody can have a go? It's not saying, well, I can't go into that because I've not got a small enough frame, and I can't go into that because, you know, I've not got the right body shape for that. I mean, this is all about body shape, isn't it? And
yeah.
Everybody's got a different shape,
yeah.
But anybody can try it.
Yeah, anyone could try it. I would suggest just speaking to someone that knows that industry, get a good coach, let them see your physique as it is, and they'll be able to guide you better as to what category you could fit into. But because there's so many, there will be one that will work for you.
And how have you seen it change as well, Martine? You know, you've almost inspired a generation yourself with people coming to you asking for your help. I mean, how pleasing is it for you to see it as popular as it is?
It's great. I think it gives people something to train for. because it encourages people to stay within the health and fitness. So before, people just go to the gym and train, people say, yeah, look, you look good, and you get that recognition. But when you aim to compete with something, it keeps you in a routine. It gives you motivation to carry on, it gives you something to aim for. And then you go from being someone that regularly goes to the gym to then achieving something which others might seem is not possible. So then therefore they will then inspire more people. And I think it just gives people something to aim for. And it's great for people to have goals and stick with them and to achieve them.
So it's almost like a knock-on effect. Like you say, if you're out with your friends, you know, for instance, my wife last night, there was five other friends were around. All of a sudden, you can see how it works, can't you? One of them does it. And you know what they're like? You know, all of a sudden, it's kind of like, oh, actually, you know, Naomi's done that. I'll have a go at that. And it's very much like that, isn't it? Which is very positive, surely.
Yeah, it is positive. I think what you've got to remember is, if you don't know much about it, to research it. Because when you do look at pictures on Instagram, it is quite easy to think, oh, I want to look like that. But you might not realise that that's how they looked on that day of the competition, and not all year round, because there is an off season where you either bulk up, gain weight, whatever it is you need to do to for your next competition prep. But as long as you keep in mind reality and not perception, that people train very hard all year round for a competition. So yes, they'll look absolutely amazing on the day, but then they don't look like that all year round.
It's not instant.
It's not instant. Just that, you know, you can't get it in 5 minutes. You've got to work hard for it. And it's worth working hard for.
And, you know, working hard, and you were saying about new mums as well. I mean, tell me what you're currently doing at the minute, because, again, this is inspiring another range of people, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, my career went from powerlifting, bikini, ninja warrior athlete when I went on that. And then after that, I got married, I had a baby, and then I transformed my own body first, just with the knowledge that I knew. And then I decided, let me try and help mums further. Because I know when you first have a baby, it's hectic, you're tired, you're exhausted, you've not got that much time, you might not want to go to a gym, and you might have been to a gym before but been intimidated. So I put together various different programs that women can do it at home around their baby schedule and get fit and feel better and give them more confidence, because you do have a bit of a knock on. Your confidence does take a bit of a knock when you have a baby and you've been out of the scene for a little bit. Because I felt that coming back to training, when I did come back, is that so much has moved on since then. So many more categories have opened up. People have got a lot stronger. People are achieving this. And you feel like, because you've been in a little mummy bubble, that it does knock your confidence a bit. So my aim is to motivate and give women confidence that they deserve and they need, and get them fitter from home with the programmes that I offer.
Is that a case as well? You know, something now, Martin, that you've been through, you can say, look, I've done this, you know, you know, having first-hand experience of becoming a mum. You know, is there a problem, do you think, as well, with body confidence and with women, you know, perhaps looking in the mirror after having a baby and becoming a little bit down because, you know, things have changed?
Yeah, things definitely do change. My body's changed. And I think what I try and get across is what I teach is that, don't look at, people say, I want to get my body back, but you won't get your body back because your body's changed. Think about transforming your body from now on, because you can get an amazing body. It won't be exactly the same, but it'll still be amazing, or it may be better than. So that's what I try and instill in people when they follow me for advice on things like that.
And what have been some of the success stories so far that you've heard, that you've been helping with people?
Everything I do is online, so I get feedback through Facebook comments and testimonials that way. But I think people like that they can download it, they can do it, they've got a schedule to follow. I'm in their inbox every single day, and they like that the constant follow on the spot. I don't just leave them. You don't just buy a product and that's it, you're on your own, you complete it. Because I know people need to be held accountable. They need to have that daily motivation to keep going with it.
And is it a case then of certainly doing this, seeing your body change? Is it gaining confidence all the time, gaining a smile, and just putting that back into life? You know, putting that smile back in and getting back going again and thinking, blimey, actually, you know what, with Martine's help, that wasn't too bad at all.
Yeah, exactly. People have got they think that they haven't got time, they won't be able to fit it in. But I've said, look, just get up, just do 10 squats. Just do 10 squats, do 10 squats, get it done. And they're like, yeah, okay, I did find time to do 10 squats. Maybe tomorrow I can do 20 squats. And try and find a way to fit it into their schedule. Because there is a way, you just got to reprioritise. And with me in your inbox getting you to do stuff and reminding you, oh, you've not opened that email, you know you were supposed to do 10 squats yesterday, or whatever the workout is. Start small and build yourself up steadily, rather than trying to jump straight back in, which is what I had to tell myself not to do, because I thought, yeah, I just want to go back in the gym or lift heavy weights, but I couldn't. I needed to rebuild my body, because a massive change happens when you have a baby. Your body changes in ways that you won't believe, and you feel completely different. You can't just jump straight back in there. You need to take time and build it back up. Well, I suggest it.
Well, no, definitely. And I think that's why it's so important, isn't it? Because you've been there, you've done that, Martine, you know, and you know exactly what it involves. How can people find out more information? You know, how can they follow, you've got a blog or website if they want, they're thinking, actually, you know what? It is time I got in touch with Martine, actually. She's my lady. That's what I need to know. How can they do that?
Well, I offer a free 30-day Yummy Mummy Squat Challenge, which is basically what I was describing, something to do every single day with email support from me. And if you want to get that, you can go to offers.martinesmummydiary.com. So that's offers, O-F-F-E-R-S, dot Martines, M-A-R-T-I-N-E-S, mummydiary.com. It's completely free. Download it and you'll be introduced to me, my story, my background, and I will help you along the way.
And if they, you keep a diary as well online, don't you? If people want to find that, how do they get that?
They can just go to martinesmummydiary.com. I blog about all sorts of things that happen in my life and stuff that my daughter does, and it's all on there for people to see if they want to read it and keep in touch.
It's been great having you, and thank you so much for joining us. And if anybody wants to get in touch with Martine, as she said, you've been there, she's done it. All you need to do is www.martinesmummydiary.com. Martine Warman, thanks for joining us on BBC Radio Leicester.
Thanks for having me.